Cusby. Response to a video that Reverend Heather had shared with us a while ago about these beautiful little birds and their murmurations. So that was Ed's inspiration. How about another hand for Ed?
Yes.
And now you get to inspire us all by joining us in singing. I'm so grateful.
Welcome to our wonderful center. I want to give a shout out to Kathy Story. Have you seen her little creation back there?
Yeah.
Edible turkeys.
Thank you.
Googly eyes and well, I don't know what else is back there. Woo! You know, now I'm just going to start. We're going to do the Flames of Faith because that's what our center is about. We believe in an openness, an awareness, a consciousness that God is everywhere, all thoughts, all religions, all sentient beings, that we're not alone. We're part of the one. So we're going to read Lighting of the Flames of Faith. And we perform this ceremony to promote the universal consciousness of life, which acknowledges that all peoples, all faiths, all sentient beings come from one great universal presence, which we call Spirit. Fundamental to this truth is the unifying nature of religious thought and experience, which we will honor here today. We light the candle for the Tao, honoring the universal path of harmony, equilibrium, and the natural way. We light the candle for the shamanic traditions, honoring the beliefs and the practices of all indigenous people, the way of primal spirituality. We light the candle for Hinduism, honoring the path of knowledge, action, and devotion. light the candle for Judaism, honoring the ethical path of living by a sacred law. We light the candle for all forms of Buddhism, honoring the Four Noble Truths and the path of compassion. We light the candle for all forms of Christianity, honoring the Christ consciousness as the path of love. We light the candle for all forms of Islam, honoring the path of compliance with the will of God as the highest calling. We light the candle for the universalistic religion of Baha'i, honoring the path of unity and peace. We light the candle for all forms of new thought, honoring the metaphysical path of mental healing through the practice of universal spiritual principles. As practitioner Tony Sparks lights that last candle, let it represent the path that brought you here this morning. And on that path this morning, would you join me in a prayer, meditation, a way to quiet your mind, just to shut off that brain, stop thinking about dessert, and know with me that right here and right now, we are one, we are connected with the holy, the sacred, the divine. We are part of that magic, that spirituality, that called God. We are God's children, we are God's parts and pieces, and we are God's consciousness. And it is up to us to make a difference in this world through our intentions, through our desires, through our wills, to make this a better place, to make our children proud, to make the world sing with joy and happiness. That is our goal. That is our task. That is our mission. We are not alone. As we look around us, we are surrounded by people with like-mindedness, with the ability to change, to make a difference, to be our friends, to be our support system, to be our family. As we say, thank you, God, we are grateful for being alive, because the alternative is not very good. So as I release this to the universe, I know it's all done, totally complete. And together we say,
and so it is.
And so it is. Tony, Sandy, Bobby, doing the affirmation. Hey, Kevin.
Hello, my family of choice. I want to do a shout out to the animal ministry who saved 12 turkeys. We are feeding 12 turkeys for a year. Just for you know. We are feeding that. Okay. Please join me in our declaration, please. I believe in God, the one creative intelligence, operating through the universe and operating throughout my entire being, now and always. I believe this perfect spirit operates upon the law of mind and creates my experience exactly according to my belief. I believe this perfect creative intelligence can be used by me and by every other person to produce health, abundance, and love in mind, body, and global life experience. I use it now, and I rejoice in it, and so it is. All right, and now here is our affirmation. Say it like you mean it.
I know that where I stand is holy ground. I am made in the image of the divine. Everyone sparkles with divinity. I am blessed by your presence, and you are blessed by mine. And so it is.
Thank you, Kathy. Please welcome our soloist today, Melissa Suzanne.
Going on. morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I am delighted. Thank you so much to be here this morning, and you all look just gorgeous. One of my teachers, Dr. Tom Costa from the Palm Desert Church, used to tell me, he said, don't worry about coming up, and don't worry about, you know, speaking in front of people. He said, just remember, it's the Father within that doeth the work. So he said, just open your mouth and let Spirit speak through you. So I hope Spirit knows what I'm talking about this morning.
That's what Spirit
says. I have faith, okay? So our title this morning is Multiplying Our Blessings. What a great title. What a wonderful thing to remember. And I know that every one of you can think of at least 10 things that multiply your blessings and what you're grateful for. So I want to hear a couple of them.
Service.
Service, very good.
Family.
What's that?
Walking in the harbor.
Yeah.
Family.
Family.
Friends.
Friends.
Puppy dogs.
Googly eyes.
Thanksgiving, yes.
Money.
Puppy dogs, yeah. Multiply your blessings. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Brothers really do multiply our blessings. Thursday nights and I believe so much fun. Great. So you can think of so many things and so many ways to multiply our blessings. So that's my topic this morning. So we're going to start. We're going to read a quote by Dr. Ernest Holmes. He's the founder of Science of Mind, and he says this: divine intelligence guides me in love, in joy, and in complete self-expression. Desiring that the law of good alone shall control me, I bless and prosper everything I am doing. I multiply every activity, and I accept and expect happiness and complete success. Yes. End of quote. Yes. So this morning we're going to start out with a song, and you're going to sing it with me. It's very easy. So Mary, we'll put that on, please. Mary, will you put that on, please? Here we go.
Mary.
Can you see it through this? I'll just move this over. And turn that music up. Let's hear it. Thank you. This one makes me cry.
Why have you come
Something you must do. Love yourself. You have to love yourself before you can give any love out there. The love that fills our being is God's love. God created us out of love. Each one of us were created out of this divine love. Each one of us is unique and special and are here on this planet at this time on purpose. Amen. You are here on purpose for a purpose, and that purpose is to love.
To love.
That's why we're here. We are to be the expression of this divine energy. I remember there was a point in my ministerial training with Dr. Heather, that I was having difficulty and having a problem moving forward on my spiritual path. And I had thought that I had released all my guilt and my shame and my blame from my past life decisions. Not my past life. This not the last one, but this one. Last one I don't even remember. But anyway, this one, this life, my past decisions, that's what I meant to say. I had thought that I had worked on that and let it all go, you know, let that guilt go and that all, let it all go. Obviously, I hadn't because I couldn't move forward. And until we forgive ourselves, we cannot move forward. Until we forgive, we cannot continue on and move forward. Thank you. Such a lovely act of kindness. Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, absolutely. So I went to Dr. Heather, of course, and I told her, and so through her love, her support, her guidance, and her understanding, we worked through it. And I finally got it released. I released the guilt, I released the shame, and I released the blaming myself, and I forgave myself. Now my family, my girls and my mom and everybody, they'd already forgiven me. It was me that I had to forgive myself. So there's no point in holding on to any regrets from your past. Today is a new day. Move forward. It's time to let it all go, every bit of it. So there will never be another you. Because God does not make mistakes. And you are perfect just the way you are. So under the umbrella of love, there's other words that we can use, like empathy, kindness, compassion, understanding, caring, All those things are all the qualities of God, and all those things, all those feelings, all those qualities live and move and reside within each one of you. It's who you are. I was a good friend of Dr. Louise Hay at the time when she created the mirror work. And if you hadn't heard about that, all it is simply looking at yourself in the mirror, looking into your own eyes, and telling yourself you love you. So this is your homework this week. Go home, look into the mirror, look into the eyes of God, which are your eyes, and you can say, I love you, Judy. Wait, you don't have to say Judy. Okay. Although, I'd love it if you did. Wonderful, thank you. Okay, you can say that, that's good. But then put your name in there. I love you, blank. Okay, and do it. I had a friend that, it was like 20 years ago, I told her she was just feeling not good about herself. I said, do this. She couldn't do it. She couldn't look herself in the eyes and tell herself she loves you. I love you. You're my best friend. You're doing the best you can. You are moving forward. You are a beautiful person. Just, I love you. So, all right, now where am I? Okay, so,
Friend of Louise Hay.
The mirror work is a really powerful spiritual practice, along with, your meditation, your prayer, your inspirational reading. But the mirror work is really powerful, and it really works for me. So we start off with ourselves, and then we're filled up, and then we have the opportunity to give that love out. And I wanted to start with the earth. Mother Earth. Let's love our Mother Earth.
Teach it.
Amen.
And we plant trees. Yeah. We work to have clean water and clean air. We reuse and we recycle. So for 50 years, I've been recycling. And when my girls were little, they said, I don't know what you're doing, Mom. Everybody else just throws all that glass and that plastic in the trash. But I recycled. And I said, I'm doing this for your children and your grandchildren so that they have a beautiful planet to live on. We all know that there's no big or small in the mind of God. Every little act of kindness makes a difference. Just like what you just did for me. Thank you. Every act makes a difference. So when you go on your walk, take a bag and fill it with trash on your walk. There's always trash there to pick up. When you see somebody walking down the street, you pass somebody, look them in the eye. Give them a smile or a kind gesture. Every act of kindness makes a difference. Our friend Mary Elliott, who used to come to the center, moved to Arkansas. And last week I was talking to her, and she told me this story about her sister Kay, who moved to the Bay Area. And I'm going to read it to you. We have a picture that we're going to put up. I'm going to read it to you because so I can get it just right. So her sister's name is. That's it. Yeah. Her sister name is Kay. So Kay was out in her hallway. Had noticed a few new faces, so she held out her hand and introduced herself to William, the father, and then asked the little girl what her name was, and she replied, Caitlin. They were just moving in. This was right around Halloween. When Kay was out, she noticed that some scary figurines for Halloween, and she picked up two. On her way home, she left one of the little figures by Caitlin's door. She didn't hear anything for a while. Then she got a note on her door from William, the dad, asking if she was the nice lady that left the little gift for Caitlin. And if she was, to please text him her phone number so that they could ask her out for coffee. So then Caitlin responded, and she said that she and her dad would like to take Kay out for coffee. So they did that on Friday or Saturday. Anyway, Caitlin is 10. And has been taking drawing lessons. So she made this present for Kay, a drawing of a kitten. And she put her name on it, says at the bottom, Kay. Kay is now hunting for a frame, and that will fit it, and she wants to keep its integrity with both her name and the signature of the artist. Kay turned 84 and has been living in Los Gatos for the last 2 years, maybe three. It's a large apartment complex, and she goes on her daily 4 mile walks. She does yoga, and she joined a happy wine hour twice a month in her apartment complex. She also made friends with another little girl and her mother, and the daughter plays the cello, and Kay goes to her concerts. While her daughters and son live in the Bay Area also, she is not dependent on them for entertainment. Of course, they are very good to their mom, sees her often, and Kay goes to the same church as one of her daughters. And Mary says, I'm proud of how she made these huge adjustments. She's living alone for the first time in her life, and she relocated and adjusting to a new area, finding her way around and making new acquaintances. And she brings fresh bagels to the office and maintenance people every Monday, so she gets really good service. An act of kindness, one little gesture, putting a little figurine, and then opens new doors, meets new people. You connect heart to heart. Yesterday, my mom said to me, thanks, Judy, for throwing my paper up on the driveway so she didn't have to walk in the street to get it. And I went, wasn't me. So a nice neighbor threw her paper up. It's a small act of kindness, but it makes a difference. It makes a difference. When we are blessed and we give out our blessings, they're multiplied by 1,000 times. I have found that the best way to multiply my blessings is by being grateful. I know many of us write a gratitude journal. Gratitude for all the things in our life, and you know, hundreds of pages, because there's so much to be grateful for. Meister Eckhart said, if the only prayer you ever say in your life was thank you, it would suffice. So thank you for my eyes, that I can see the beauty around me. Thank you for my feet and my legs that carry my body and move me forward. Thank you for my family and my friends who love and support me. Thank you for the science of mind philosophy that gives me the spiritual tools and guidance for a better life. Thank you for this center, where I can connect, expand, and grow in love. So the next topic, love, serve, remember, is serve. And what does serve mean? Serve is to answer the need of something. Serve is to furnish or supply with something needed or desired. It's to be a servant, one who serves one another. It's to provide services and benefits of or help. So that is the what. So what is the how? How do we serve? Every way. Everything you do is in service. There are unlimited ways to serve. I started attending this center in 1989, and I wanted to meet the people, I wanted to connect, so I started volunteering. I volunteered for an usher and hospitality, and I volunteered for anything that came along. So we used to have Adventure in Faith. I volunteered to be on that committee and do that. I volunteered to have people in my home for 15 years to have those groups. I volunteered. And in 1999, when Dr. Heather came to our center, I volunteered to be on the Board of Trustees. And I did that for 8 years. And I got to know everybody. I connected. I made lifelong friends here at this center because of that connection. We give of our love. We give of ourselves. when we give of ourselves, our blessings expand and grow. And there are three primary ways to serve. It's our time, our talents, and our treasure. And I know that most of you in this room this morning, you do give of your time, your talents, and your treasure. We have choir, we have hospitality, we have practitioners, teachers, people that do the sound and do the video, and all the people that serve and volunteer in the center. Make your blessings grow and expand. And we're grateful for every single one of you. I personally practice the spiritual law of tithing. And that means giving a portion of my treasure back to where I'm spiritually fed. And I give that in the form of money. It is a spiritual law, just like gravity. So it's just as, you know, if I jump off this building, I'm going to hit the ground. And that the law of tithing is the same way. It works every single time. I'm living proof of that. The third way we multiply our blessings is to remember. Remember. Remember who we are. We are spiritual beings, and we're having a fantastic, exciting, sometimes bumpy human experience. But we're here to remember who we are. We've all heard the statement, I am that I am.
Yeah.
And I've heard it for years, and I quite didn't know what it meant. I am, well, I am is the name of God. So I am that I am. In the Science of Mind textbook, it explains it this way. I am is both individual and universal. The individual I is a part of the universal I am. I am that I am. In other words, we are all one with the divine intelligence. We are one with this perfect energy. And we unify with all these qualities of God. I'm going to read something out of the Science of Mind textbook, page 549. After I get my glasses. This is in the back of the meditations. Within thee is the fullness of life. Within thee is complete joy and everlasting peace. Within thee is all. Thou art in me as I am in thee, and we are all in all. My life is full and complete within me, and that life I give to all men freely. And from all I receive, again, that which I have given, for it is one in all. I am one with the fullness of all life. There's some great stuff in the back of that book. You really ought to look at it. Really some wonderful, wonderful meditations and stuff. It's beautiful. So Melissa Felipe has a chant, and it's called, I Am Remembering Who I Am, and we've chanted it many times here. And I love it because I can put that thing on and listen to it when I forget. Because sometimes we forget why we're here, what our purpose is, and remember that we are God in the expression. Jalaluddin Rumi, the 13th century Sufi poet, says this about remembering who we are. What you seek is seeking you. You are not a drop in the ocean. You are the entire ocean in one drop. We are the mirror as well as the face in it. We are tasting the taste of eternity this minute. We are pain and what cures pain. We are the sweet, cold water as well as the jug that pours. Everything is in the universe is within you. Ask all from yourself. When we wake up and we remember who we are, then, only then, we are truly free. Today, I'm alive, awake, and aware. Please say that with me.
Today, I'm alive, awake, and aware.
One more time with conviction.
Today, I'm alive, awake, and aware.
And aware, absolutely. So all of our blessings are multiplied when we love, when we serve, and we remember who we are. And so it is.
So it is.
Most holy and sacred moment, we remember who we are, and we remember that there is only one life, one love, one divine essence, and this one is first cause to all of creation. This one is the love of Jesus. It is the peace of Gandhi, and it is the compassion of the Buddha. This one is all in all. It is infinite intelligence, for it is God. And I know that each one of us has all the qualities of God within us. We are loving, we are kind, we care, we have empathy. And we know that we are a center of love. For we are made in the image and likeness of this divine presence. And this love fills us up. Fills us up and overflows into our community. Into everything we see, everything we touch, everything we do and think. So I affirm and I decree that in this moment, all is well. And that this truth this morning was spoken and heard, and that each one of us leaves this morning with this heart full of joy and a purpose and knowing that we are alive, awake, and aware in every moment. And so my heart is full of gratitude and joy and deep thanksgiving for this teaching, for this time together, for this love. And I anchor this prayer in love, in service, and in remembering as we say together,
and so it is.
Now, Melissa.
You will recognize this song in the silence. If you know it, I encourage you to sing along with me and take the words in and remember what it is saying, a message I so often need to hear myself, quieting the mind and having that peace. Mm-hmm.
It's time for our offering. If the stewards would come forward, please. This is time to see if that spiritual practice, that spiritual law works, right? Did you forget who you were?
I wasn't told.
Oh, okay, you weren't told. I'll remember, I meant remind
I'm
you
remembering.
Who you are. She's remembering that I touched someone this morning. All righty. Let's take our gift in our hand and feel that energy of God. Feel that energy of love flowing through our gift, expanding and growing and blessing each and every person in this room and every person that this gift touches when it is serves, when it expands and grows. So let's say our prosperity affirmation. My offering is my acceptance of God as the source of my supply, and it symbolizes my faith in the abundant flow of this supply.
is within your heart. That was absolutely beautiful. Let's give him another hand. Thank you so much. We are so blessed. We are so blessed to have all of you here at the center. And we're blessed to have volunteers. So if you've been volunteering this week, please stand so we can give you a lot of love. Thank you. This is how we connect. Wonderful. And a part of these people are the practitioners, which absolutely include a minister. A minister is a practitioner first, always a practitioner first. And these people were trained in the art and the science of the Science of Mind affirmative prayer. And they can see through the stuff, through the junk, through the circumstances, through the situation, into the truth of who you are. So today we have three that are here to serve you. Tony Sparks, Cheryl Lyman, and Kathy Story. And they will be at the tables back here, and then one in the tranquility room. If you would like a taste of affirmative prayer and make your life better. And there's a piece of paper that has all the names of all the practitioners, or they're in the back of the room with their pictures. Their business cards are up there. You can give them a call and make an appointment with them. And
change your life.
They can help you through. Change your life. Absolutely change your life. So do we have any new people today? We'd like to give you a gift. If you would like to stand or raise your hand. Don't see any today. We're always welcome to have new people come. And so bring a friend. Yes. Bring a friend next week, or Thanksgiving Eve, yes. So, and then we have announcements.
But of course, CBQ, the white zone is for the immediate loading and unloading of passengers. Well, last time we did announcements, we covered all of the worst case scenarios, if you recall. So this time we will cover all the best case scenarios. So listen closely for the information that we have could change your life.
If you take the first step, you never know where it could lead. Today, you could join Conscious Connections right here in the sanctuary for a brief discussion about today's topic. And if you do so, it is certainly possible that you will meet your new best friend, or even that special person that completes your life. It meets from 12 to 12:30, and childcare is available.
This Wednesday is our Thanksgiving Eve service. This is a special time when we come together as a spiritual community to share our gratitude and our sweets. So plan to be there with a dessert to share and invite your friends or family. And on the way home, you'll be filled with so much gratitude that you will be attracting good from all directions. And if you stop at the gas station and buy a lottery ticket, you could win $1 million. And the service is from 7 to 8.
Next Sunday is the first Sunday of the month, which means it's our communal feast. The time when you get to share the food you lovingly prepare and commune with our blessed community. All the food is prepared with extra love, and you might discover that secret holiday food that tastes great and makes you lose weight at the same time.
December 8th is our annual holiday boutique and brunch, so plan to stay after the service, enjoy a delicious meal, and shop for unique gifts crafted by our spiritual family. And you'll probably find that perfect gift for everyone, and the one that you give to your boss will impress her so much with your good taste that she will promote you and give you a huge raise.
Yes!
On December 15th, after the service at 12:30, our very own Jennifer Krieg will present messages from spirit and group healing. Attendance here is sure to allow you to find that missing piece of the puzzle that will complete your transformation and enlightenment and bring you to nirvana and perfect health. Yes. There is more information about this on the kiosk.
And the Michael Paul Smith Christmas concert is coming up on December 22nd after the service. Get into the holiday spirit and bring the whole family, and I mean the whole family. If you bring crotchety old Uncle Mortimer, he will be so moved, touched, and inspired that he will start singing along and probably put you back into the will.
There's always so much going on here at CSLCV. So take your inserts home with you and look them over. And make sure you look for the coded messages that have been hidden in there to find the treasure map to the chest of gold doubloons.
And now, the future Olympic medal and Nobel Prize winners, our children.